In our last video, we looked at what exactly a computer system was, and we defined a digital computer system as being something that had an input which produced an output based on some processing system in the middle. What we'll do in this video is take a look at very simple processing systems or very simple digital computer systems. For example, take look at a very simple porch light or a garage light. Typically, garage lights or porch lights like these are available in a lot of homes. Here's a porch light that turns on the light if it is dark outside and stays on until it's morning time. So let's use this particular porch light as an example to see if we can relate as to exactly what the input to the system is, what the output is, and what the processing logic might be. Okay. So what is the input to the system? The input is a sensor that measures the brightness of brightness outside. The output is the light or the light bulb being turned on. So what is the processing logic here? So the processing logic basically is this particular statement that we stated in plain English. We want to take the plain English statement and decipher what the processing logic would be if we were a computer. The processing logic basically relates the input, which is sensor that measures brightness in this case, to an output, which is the light. So what is the processing logic in this case? Light, if we write it in the form of an expression, the computer's processing logic would be that the light is equal to not bright. So this basically means the output light is turned on if it is not bright outside. Okay, so this is the input. If it is not bright outside, this is the processing logic that takes place, which results in the output light bulb being turned on. So input, output, and the computer's processing logic. Let's make this a lot more complicated. So here's an example of something else I could find it on Ace Hardware. This particular kind of porch light or a garage light basically turns on the light not only if it is dark outside, but also only if it is dark outside and there is some sort of a motion. So in plain English, I would say if it is dark outside and a motion sensor detects someone at the door, turn on the lights. So let's go through this particular example and see if we can find out what the input is, what the output is, and what the processing logic of this computing system might be. Okay? So the input is a sensor that measures the brightness, and then the sensor that measures or detects the motion. The output again is the light bulb, and the computer's processing logic says, if let's take a look at it this in plain English description again. If it is dark outside, so the sensor is saying it is not bright outside, and there's motion outside, then we should have the light on. So looking at the processing logic, here's the input from the motion sensor. So if there is motion outside and it is not bright outside, meaning it's dark outside, then the left-hand side of this expression, the light bulb should come on. So that's the computer's processing logic. Let's get a lot more complicated. What if I had this particular kind of scenario? I love to work outside, especially when it's dark. And I don't want to have to wave my hand at the motion sensor so that I can have light outside when I'm doing work. So maybe I tell you, if it is dark outside and a motion sensor detects someone at the door, or I manually turn the switch on, then keep the lights on. So if it is dark outside and motion sensor detects someone at the door, or the light switch is manually turned on, then turn on the lights. So what are my inputs? In this case, my inputs are a sensor that measures brightness, just like before, a sensor that detects motion, just like before, and a manual switch. What is my output? The output is a light bulb, just like before. And the processing logic for this particular case is, if it's, so light sensor detects whether it's light or dark outside. So if it's not bright outside, and if the motion sensor detects its movement, or if my switch is manually turned on. So my light bulb should come on if there's motion, and if it's dark outside, or if I turn on the switch manually. So that's my simple processing logic. So here are three different versions of a computing systems of different degrees of complexity. Not bright, that was a very simple computing system. A little more complicated systems, which was motion and not bright. And finally, the processing system on the most complicated system we looked at also involved a manual switch. So motion and not bright, or if the switch is turned on. So a computer system is basically something that acts on these inputs with some logic that's embedded in it to produce a desired output.